Section 8, Computer Networking Fundamental, Introduction. In the previous study section, we discussed how data is represented in computer system. Therefore, in this study session, we will discuss the basics of networking. We will start with a little history that describes how the networking industry evolved. We will then move on to a section that describes how a LAN is built, essentially the necessary components like NIC cards and cables. We then cover LAN topologies. And finally, we will discuss the key networking devices, hubs, bridges, switches, and routers. Learning outcomes. When you have studied this session, you should be able to outline history of computer networking, analyze local area network LAN and its components, describe LAN topologies, utilize LAN/WAN devices. Networking history. From a historical perspective, electronic communication has actually been around a long time, beginning with Samuel Morse and the telegraph. He sent the first telegraph message May 24, 1844, from Washington, D.C. to Baltimore, M.D., 37 miles away. The message, what had got wrought? Less than 25 years later, Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone, beating out a competitor to the patent office only by a couple of hours on Valentine's Day in 1867. This led to the development of the ultimate analog network, the telephone system. The first bit-oriented language device was developed by Emil Baldaud, the printing telegraph. By bit-oriented, we mean the device sent pulses of electricity which were either positive or had no voltage at all. These machines did not use Morse code. Baldaud's five-level code sent five pulses down the wire for each character transmitted. The machines did the encoding and decoding, eliminating the need for operators at both ends of the wires. For the first time, electronic messages could be sent by anyone. LAN, Local Area Network. The term Local Area Network, or LAN, describes of all the devices that communicate together printers, file server, computers, and perhaps even a host computer. However, the LAN is constrained by distance. The transmission technologies used in LAN applications do not operate at speed over long distances. LAN distances are in the range of 100 meters to 3 kilometers. This range can change as new technologies emerge. For systems from different manufacturers to interoperative, be it a printer, PC, and file server, they must be developed and manufactured according to industry-wide protocols and standards. Most of the network administrator's tasks deal with LANs. Major characteristics of LANs are: 1. The network operates within a building or floor of a building. The geographical scope for ever more powerful LAN desktop devices running more powerful applications is for less area per LAN. 2. LANs provide multiple connected desktop devices, usually PCs, with access to high bandwidth media. 3. An enterprise purchases the media and connections used in the LAN. The enterprise can privately control the LAN as it chooses. 4. LANs rarely shut down or restrict access to connected workstations. Local services are usually always available. 5. By definition, the LAN connects physically adjacent devices on the media. Components of LAN: Network Operating System, NOS. In order for computers to be able to communicate with each other, they must first have the networking software that tells them how to do so. Without the software, the system will function simply as a standalone, unable to utilize any of the resources on the network. Network operating software may be installed by the factory, eliminating the need for you to purchase it, for example, Apple Talk, or you may install it yourself. Component of LAN Network Interface Card, NIC. The NIC also provides the physical connection between the computer and the transmission cable, also called media. This connection is made through the connector port. Examples of transmission media are Ethernet, token ring, and FDDI. In addition to network operating software, each network device must also have a network interface card. These cards today are also referred to as adapters, as in Ethernet adapter card or token ring adapter card. The NIC card amplifies electronic signals which are generally very weak within the computer system itself. The NIC is also responsible for packaging data for transmission and for controlling access to the network cable. When the data is packaged properly and the timing is right, the NIC will push the data stream onto the cable. Components of LAN, wiring hub. In order to have a network, you must have at least two devices that communicate with each other. In this simple model, it is a computer and a printer. The printer also has an NIC installed, for example, an HP Jet Direct card, which in turn is plugged into a wiring hub. The computer system is also plugged into the hub, which facilitates communication between the two devices. Additional components such as a server, a few more PCs, and a scanner may be connected to the hub. With this connection, all network components would have access to all other network components. The benefit of building this network is that by sharing resources, a company can afford higher quality components. For example, instead of providing an inkjet printer for every PC, a company may purchase a laser printer which is faster, higher capacity, and higher quality than the inkjet to attach to a network. Then, all computers on that network have access to the higher quality printer. Components of LAN, cables or transmission media. The wires connecting the various devices together are referred to as cables. Cable prices range from inexpensive to very costly and can comprise of a significant cost of the network itself. 1. Cables are one example of transmission media. Media are various physical environments through which transmission signals pass. Common network media include twisted pair, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, and the atmosphere through which microwave, laser, and infrared transmission occurs. Another term for this is physical media. Note that not all wiring hubs support all medium types. The other component shown in below is the connector. 2. As their name implies, the connector is the physical location where the NIC card and the cabling connect. 3. Registered jack, RJ connectors were originally used to connect telephone lines. RJ connectors are now used for telephone connections and for 10BASE-T and other types of network connections. Different connectors are able to support different speeds of transmission because of their design and the materials used in their manufacture. 4. RJ11 connectors are used for telephones, faxes, and modems. RJ45 connectors are used for NIC cards, 10BASE-T cabling, and ISDN lines. Network cabling. Cable is the actual physical part upon which an electrical signal travels as it moves from one component to another. Transmission protocols determine how NIC cards take turns transmitting data onto the cable. Remember that we discussed how LAN cables baseband carry one signal, while WAN cables broadband carry multiple signals. There are three primary cable types. 1. Twisted pair or copper. 2. Coaxial cable. And 3. Fiber optic cable. twisted pair or copper. 1. Unshielded twisted pair UTP is a 4-pair wire medium used in a variety of networks. It does not require the fixed spacing between connections that is necessary with coaxial type connections. There are 5 types of UTP cabling commonly used as shown below. Category 1. Used for telephone communications. It is not suitable for transmitting data. Category 2. Capable of transmitting data at speeds up to 4 Mbps. Category 3. Used in 10 base T networks and can transmit data at speeds up to 10 Mbps. Category 4. Used in token ring networks and can transmit data at speeds up to 16 Mbps. Category 5 can transmit data at speeds up to 100 Mbps. 2. Shielded Twisted Pair STP is a 2-pair wiring medium used in a variety of network implementations. STP cabling has a layer of shielded insulation to reduce EMI. Token ring runs on STP. Using UTP and STP, speed is usually satisfactory for local area distances. These are the least expensive media for data communication, although UTP is cheaper than STP. Coaxial cable. Coaxial cable consists of a solid copper core surrounded by an insulator, a combination shield and ground wire, and an outer protective jacket. The shielding on coaxial cable makes it less susceptible to interference from outside sources. It requires termination at each end of the cable, as well as a single ground connection. Coax supports 10 to 100 Mbps and is relatively inexpensive, although more costly than UTP. Coaxial can be cabled over longer distances than twisted pair cable. For example, Ethernet can run at speed over approximately 100 meters, 300 feet, or twisted pair. Using coaxial cable increases this distance to 500 meters. Fiber optic cable. Fiber optic cable consists of glass fiber surrounded by shielding protection, a plastic sheet, Kevlar reinforcing, and an outer jacket. Fiber optic cable consists of glass fiber surrounded by shielding protection, a plastic sheet, Kevlar reinforcing, and an outer jacket. There are 2 types of fiber cable. LAN topologies. You may hear the word topology used with respect to networks. Topology refers to the physical arrangement of network components and media within an enterprise networking structure. There are 4 primary kinds of LAN topologies: bus, tree, star, and ring. Bus and tree topology. Bus topology is 1. A linear LAN architecture in which transmissions from network components propagate the length of the medium and are received by all other components. 2. The bus portion is the common physical signal part composed of wires or other media across which signals can be sent from one part of a network to another, sometimes called a highway. 3. Ethernet / IEEE 802.3 networks commonly implement a bus topology. Tree topology is similar to bus topology, except that 3 networks can contain branches with multiple nodes. As in bus topology, transmissions from one component propagate the length of the medium and are received by all other components. The disadvantage of bus topology is that if the connection to any one user is broken, the entire network goes down, disrupting communication between all users. Because of this problem, bus topology is rarely used today. The advantage of bus topology is that it requires less cabling, therefore lower cost than star topology. Star topology. Stack topology is a LAN topology in which endpoints on a network are connected to a common central switch or hub by point-to-point links. Logical bus and ring topologies are often implemented physically in a star topology. The benefit of star topology is that even if the connection to any one user is broken, the network stays functioning and communication between the remaining users is not disrupted. The disadvantage of star topology is that it requires more cabling, therefore higher cost than bus topology. Star topology may be thought of as a bus in a box. Ring topology. Ring topology consists of a series of repeaters connected to one another by unidirectional transmission links to form a single closed loop. Each station on the network connects to the network at a repeater. While logically a ring, ring topologies are most often organized in a closed loop star. A ring topology that is organized as a star implements a unidirectional closed loop star instead of point-to-point links. One example of a ring topology is token ring. Redundancy is used to avoid collapse of the entire ring in the event that a connection between two components fails. LAN/WAN devices. As networking technology continues to evolve, the actual differences between networking devices is beginning to blur slightly. Routers today are switching packets faster and yielding the performance of switches. Switches, on the other hand, are being designed with more intelligence and able to act more like routers. Hubs, while traditionally not intelligent in terms of the amount of software they run, are now being designed with software that allows the hub to be intelligent, acting more like a switch. Hub. Star topology networks generally have a hub in the center of the network that connects all of the devices together using cabling. When bits hit a networking device, be the hubs, switches, or routers, the devices will strengthen the signal and then send it on its way. A hub is simple, a multi-port repeater. There is usually no software to load and no configuration required. That is, network administrators don't have to tell the device what to do. Hubs operate very much the same way as a repeater. They amplify and propagate signals received out all ports, with the exception of the port from which the data arrived. In fairly small networks, hubs work very well. However, in large networks, the limitations of hubs create problems for network managers. Bridges. Bridges improve network throughput and operate at a more intelligent level than do hubs. A bridge is considered to be a store and forward device that uses unique hardware addresses to filter traffic that would otherwise travel from one segment to another. A bridge performs the following functions. 1. Reads data frame, headers, and records source address through port segment peers. 2. Reads the destination address of incoming frames and uses recorded addresses to determine the appropriate outbound port for the frame. 3. Uses memory buffers to store frames during periods of heavy transmission and forwards them when the medium is ready. Switches. Switches use bridging technology to forward traffic between ports. They provide full dedicated transmission rate between two stations that are directly connected to the switch ports. Switches also build and maintain address tables just like bridges do. These address tables are known as content addressable memory. Replacing the two hubs and the bridge with an Ethernet switch provides the users with dedicated bandwidth. Each station has a full 10 Mbps pipe to the switch. With the switch at the center of the network, combined with the 100 Mbps links, users have greater access to the network. routers. A router has two basic functions: path determination using a variety of metrics and forwarding packets from one network to another. Routing metrics can include load on the link between devices, delay, bandwidth, and reliability, or even hop count, that is, the number of devices a packet must go through in order to reach its destination. In essence, routers will do all that bridges and switches will do, plus more. Routers have the capability of looking deeper into the data frame and applying network services based on the destination IP address. Destination and source IP addresses are a part of the network header added to a packet encapsulation at the network layer. Study section summary. In this study section, we learned that 1. LANs are designed to operate within a limited geographic area. 2. Key LAN components are computers, NOS, NICs, hubs, and cables. 3. Common LAN topologies include bus, tree, star, and ring. 4. Common LAN / 1 devices are hubs, bridges, switches, and routers. This is the end of study section 8. Thanks for listening.